From the northeastern corner of the North American continent, the port city of Halifax, Nova Scotia, Canada, we're at the inaugural Four Continents Figure Skating Championships. And this afternoon, the ladies take center stage. We are inside the Halifax Metro Center where the ladies' final group is preparing for the free skating portion of the ladies' competition in the inaugural Four Continents Figure Skating Championship. Hi everyone, I'm Tim Ryan with Olympic gold medalist and now a top coach, Carol Heiss. And Carol, welcome to the broadcasting world once again for this first ever Four Continents event.
Thank you. I'm delighted to be back, and I love the view from up here.
We also don't have that pressure being down there by the boards as a coach. What are your thoughts on this new international competition as another prelude, like the European Championships, to the upcoming World Championships?
Europeans have had their competition for years and years, and now the rest of the world has the chance to compete in front of the international judges before they go to the World Championships.
Well, I think that's obviously an asset for the skaters and perhaps the judges as well. Now, the American skaters, all three of them here, are well-placed after the short program, standing second, third, and fourth.
All three girls did solid short programs, but as everyone in skating knows, it comes down to the long program. That's because it's 4 minutes, and it gives you more time to make more mistakes, unfortunately.
Well, the top American in the short program was Amber Corwin.
Amber has a wonderful triple toe combination, which she's warming up right now, and she invariably does it under pressure. She's the most mature of the U.S. ladies and has the most senior international experience. Erin is refreshing. She has speed and flow, beautiful triple loop, which she just did in warm up, and really, it'll be interesting to see what she does under pressure here. Angela has the most technically perfect triple jumps. What she needs to do is do it when it counts.
Angela Nikodinov was fourth at the recent U.S. National Championships, struggled in the short program, finished strongly in the free skate. Well, the draw shows that Tatiana Malanina from Uzbekistan will be first on the ice, followed by Erin Pearl, and then Nikodinov, Amber Corwin, and Fumie Suguri from Japan will skate last. Malanina, 26-year-old, from Tashkent, grew up in Russia, born in Novosibirsk. Eighth at the Nagano Olympic Games.
Tatiana's a good basic skater. The jumps are technically correct, nice and high. She's straight in the air. Doesn't quite have the flair, obviously, of a Michelle Kwan. Another good triple flip jump here. She looks like she's off to a very strong start.
She comes in here as the favorite in this competition.
Sloppy landing on the triple loop. But this won't be too costly for her in this program. redeems herself by doing a nice triple salve double toe combination.
Melanina skating to the music from the soundtrack of Aladdin, and you can see her choreography befitting that style. We mentioned Melanina is one of the favorites here, Carol. Of course, the top Europeans are not here, and nor is Michelle Kwan, the U.S. champion. Is passing this up to prepare to go directly to the World Championships in Helsinki. Melanina now has been living the last 6 months in Virginia, training there with her boyfriend, Roman Skornyakov, who is competing in the men's competition here in Halifax.
Another mistake on the second double axel. Now it'll be interesting to see what happens. She can't make another mistake. Sequence for the ladies and their long program. Well done with nice speed. That was supposed to be a triple Lutz, but of course she has the option to double it.
Tatiana Melanina from Uzbekistan. She was the leader after the short program, and she has set the standard here in this final group in the free skate. We'll have her marks when we return. And next to skate will be the first of the three Americans who are all in the final group, 16-year-old Erin Pearl, in her first senior international event. She looks relaxed.
NBC Sports coverage of the Four Continents Figure Skating Championships is brought to you by Genuine Chevrolet, the cars more Americans trust.
Now, relive the unforgettable memories from your favorite skating superstars. Call 1-800-99-ON-ICE to own the all-new home video Superstars on Ice. Vitt, Hamill, Boitano, Bayul, Gordieva and Grinkov, Stoiko, Kwan, and many more. Call 1-800-99-ON-ICE. Only $19.95 plus shipping and handling. All skating legends, all on one video. 1-800-99-ON-ICE. Call now.
Tatiana Melanina, she got a broken flower there among her tributes thrown onto the ice in recognition of her performance.
Here we see Tatiana's opening triple Lutz. Straight, high, perfect. This is her triple loop, having trouble swinging the shoulders on the entrance, and the free leg gets stuck on the landing. But Tatiana goes on to recoup herself with this triple sow double toe combination.
I'm very tired.
Tatiana Melanina awaiting her marks. Here they come for technical merit.
Very good marks for it. Shows that triple Lutz and triple flip were important in this long program for Tatiana.
And for presentation, well, she's very happy with these. A 5-7 from France and from the U.S. Now on the ice, the youngest member of the American contingent, 16-year-old Erin Pearl from Scarborough, Maine. For more on young Aaron, let's join the third member of our broadcast team, Beth Ruyak.
Thanks, Tim. Erin Pearl has surprised a lot of people at this event, but she says she's especially surprised herself. This is her first senior international meet, and the 5.6 she received in the short program, it's the highest score of her life. She's a lot of fun to watch, and as she skates and her smile lights up this place, see if she doesn't remind you a little bit of Tara Lipinski.
I think she does when she smiles, for sure, Beth.
Next competitor represents the United States of America, Erin Pearl.
Third after the short program, and Carol, it just seems like she's having a lot of fun in this international experience at the senior level.
She always looks relaxed. Doesn't have all the triple jumps that most senior ladies have, the triple lutz and the triple flip, but the one she has, she does very well. This is a double toe, triple toe combination, and she does a double-double. Erin needs that triple toe.
First senior international competition, so like many of the skaters here, and more importantly to her as a 16-year-old in her first appearance, she's getting a chance to show the judges, the international judges here, what she can do.
And for them to see her and how she is under pressure. And down the road, this experience will be marvelous for her. With her heart and soul, and she has so much crowd appeal. Beautiful triple loop combination.
Her smile always seems so natural after she's landed a good one.
As I said, when she does something, she does it well. There's the triple toe that she needed in the combination earlier in the program.
Erin is very much into her music. She is, in fact, a musician, plays the flute.
There's been comment about the wrapping of Erin's free leg, and in that triple loop, you can see it. Double axle here is a hard time getting the free leg around. See how the judges react to that. But she still has that smile.
Hey, Erin Pearl from the United States, third after the short program. Skating here in the free skate in the final group in Halifax at the first ever Four Continents Figure Skating Championships.
Here's the double toe, and this should have been a triple toe. Right leg toed in way far behind her. Here is the triple loop, and you can see the wrapped leg on the landing. But nice combination.
Oops. 5-2, 5-3, 5-1, 5-4.
Marks for technical merit and a pair of 5-3s.
And you can see that her technical marks reflect not having a triple lutz or triple flip.
Now for presentation, a 5.6 from the Netherlands. She told Beth Rujak she had never had a 5.6 before until the short program. Well, now she's had two. Next up, Angela Nikodina from the United States. A few weeks ago in Salt Lake City, Michelle Kwan won her third United States ladies singles title as she prepares for the World Championships a few weeks from now in Helsinki. Michelle is back home training full time. Her schedule has been pointing to the Worlds all year, so she chose to skip this event in Halifax. Finishing second to Michelle, and according to many, stealing the show in Salt Lake, was 13-year-old Naomi Nari Nam from California. Her age prevented her from qualifying for this International Skating Union event here in Halifax.
I'm very sorry about the age rule. It should really be about quality of skating.
Angela Nikodina from the United States was third to Nam and Michelle Kwan at Nationals.
Angela Nikodina.
And under a bit of pressure, it's safe to say here, she's hoping to be at the World Championships in Helsinki, and the expectation is that she'll have to do well here in order to stay on the world team. ...18 years old from Spartanburg, South Carolina. Her parents emigrated here from Bulgaria. Now training at Lake Arrowhead and living in San Pedro, California.
Angela technically has the best triple jumps, really, of all the girls. Beautiful triple lutz, light, airy, clean. She just needs to have her self-confidence in this long program. Coming up, her triple flip. Perfect, easy. Angela has just left her coach, Peter Uppegaard, and she's here with her ballet teacher, Elena Cherkovskaya.
Section of music, Rachmaninoff, for Angela Nikodinoff, who not only has to impress the judges here and hopefully to get herself into a medal position, but also the executive staff of the U.S. Figure Skating Association, as she hopes to be on that world team heading to Helsinki.
That was supposed to be a triple loop jump. Now Angela's going to have to refocus herself and continue on with the program and forget about that mistake.
coming up or triple sal. Oh, Angela, refocus yourself. Once you make a mistake in this program, it's so hard to get back to it. One more strong triple jump at the end of this program. Pops her triple Lutz jump. Start bending your knees, Angela. Dig deep down in your heart and soul. Coming up here is Angela's triple toe Wally, and she definitely needs this. Good girl. Not solid, but she did it.
Angela Nikodinov, a strong finish after a somewhat soft spot during the middle of her program. Her favorite athlete is Dan Jansen. She admires his determination, but she showed some of her own, finishing her program strongly. And now she must await the marks of the judges.
Here we see this technically beautiful triple Lutz. Straight in the air, tight, beautiful landing into a double toe. Coming up now is the miss in the triple Lutz at the end of the program. Starts to rotate the shoulders, and there's no way she can even leave the ice.
Marks for technical merit.
Now, Angela's technical marks are higher than Aaron Pearl's, and this reflects the triple Lutz and triple flip.
For presentation now.
But Aaron Pearl's presentation marks are higher than Angela. It's going to be much too close to call.
Aaron Pearl had a 5-6, remember, and right now she's with our Beth Ruyak.
Thank you, Tim. Well, Aaron, the triples weren't there right off the top, but when they came, they were pretty. They were strong.
Yes, in the beginning, I felt a little tight going into the double triple, and I was a little off balance. But after that, I decided just to be aggressive and go and do the rest of my triples, or at least attempt them, and it went really well.
Really a strong wrap-up to this season, and this is the end of your competition now for this year. What do you think about skating after this season?
I'm just really thrilled and excited to go do all these great competitions. The Senior International doing very well in Nationals, and I'm probably just going to keep on working hard throughout the spring and the summer, and I'll look forward to next season.
And the break will give you a chance to get your driver's license.
Yes, I think I'll be able to do that now, take my test.
Thank you. Congratulations, Erin.
Okay, thank you.
Delightful Aaron Pearl, and now you're looking at Amber Corwin. All three Americans are in the final group. She will be next.
Okay.
Welcome back to Halifax and the free skate here for the ladies' competition. Tatiana Malanina in the lead. Angela Nikodinov did finish ahead of Aaron Pearl. The last American to skate, Amber Corwin, could catch the leader. Right now, let's go backstage to Beth Ruyak.
Thanks, Tim. Angela Nikodinov walked off stage with her coach. She started crying and leaning over. She was trying to catch her breath. Angela is pretty shaken up by her performance tonight and, of course, what it will all mean. Back to you, Tim.
Well, what it will all mean, as Beth knows, is perhaps a spot on the U.S. team at the World Championships in Helsinki. But right here in Halifax, Amber Corwin has her sights on a gold medal in these four continent championships.
Amber is the only skater here of the ladies that has senior international competitive experience. Very mature skater. This is what she's known for, her triple toe combination. Oh, hang on, Amber.
Amber Corwin, a freshman at Cal State University, Long Beach, California.
This is a jump she doesn't particularly like, the triple flip. Very well done. Now she's delighted.
Big smile.
Her double axel.
Good start for Amber Corwin. As we said, she was second after the short program, so she is still in contention here to catch the leader, Tatiana Malanina of Uzbekistan.
Triple sow, puts it into a double and can't hang on to the landing.
I think Amber, happy to be here. She got the chance when Sarah Hughes, who was fourth in the U.S. Nationals just a few weeks ago, chose not to come to this competition, and Amber Corwin happily accepting the opportunity.
She wanted to do a really good long program here because she was disappointed in how she skated at Nationals. And so far it looks like she's skating up to par.
Amber was sixth at the U.S. Nationals competition.
Triple loop coming up here. She's starting to double the triples. Now Amber's going to start saying to herself, dig in.
Clearly pleased with her performance. She finished strongly. Now it's up to the judges as to whether she can catch the leader.
Well, she can be proud of herself because she was able to regroup and do the last triple lutz and triple sacco in the program.
We'll get the marks when we return to Halifax in a moment.
I got coffee.
You got poke. Yeah, it's gonna just...
Amber Corwin from the U.S. awaiting her marks. Tim Ryan with Carol Heiss-Jenkins here in Halifax.
Here we see Amber's triple toe combination, which is her signature jump. Needed courage to pull out that free leg, but she finally does it. And then redeems herself with this triple sow double toe, the end of the program.
Strong and happy finish for Amber Corwin. Here come the marks. First for technical merit.
5-5, 5-4, 5-3, 5-4, 5-5.
five fives.
Hi, Dad. Miss you. Love you.
These marks aren't high enough to catch Tatiana Malanina. And either are the presentation marks, so Amber will have to settle for second.
Well, there's one more.
Take a wave. Take a wave. Amber Corwin, last to skate Fumiya Suguri from Japan. Fifth after the short program, she cannot catch the leader, but she could get on the podium. And if she were to win the free skate, of course, with a great performance, she could get second place. 18 years old from Yokohama, Kanagawa, Japan. Suguri was second in her national championships recently. Last year, bothered by a hip injury, missed the Olympics and the Worlds.
And she opens up with her triple lutz.
Whoa.
Oh, and she hits the board. Sounds terrible. Do you know, in Japan, all the rinks are larger and have square corners. So the Japanese have really been having problems here with the corners of the rink because they're so round.
Smaller hockey rinks in the United States and Canada, not the international size that, as you point out, many of these skaters compete in Europe and Asia.
Nice triple flip. I love her knees. What I mean is she's so soft and into the ice, but needs to check out on the triple jumps.
National champion of Japan in 1997. Fumiya's choreographer is Lori Nickel. Does the same job for Michelle Kwan.
Setting up for a triple loop. Can't quite get the free leg out. She keeps rotating the shoulders before she gets to the height of the jumps. Another triple lutz. Ah, better, but still can't get the free leg out.
Battling to get on the podium, and Carol, I think with the problem she's had early on here, that's going to be difficult for her.
Yes, she looks like she's skating with a lack of self-confidence. Pull off a nice triple toe.
So much we just take for granted that these youngsters don't feel a whole lot of pressure. Well, she's trying to make her national team for the World Championships, having finished second in the Nationals, as we mentioned earlier.
Taken her the whole program to relax and really get into the ice and do the jumps. She was better at the end.
Fumiya Suguri of Japan, just 18 years old. Will probably not make the podium here, but hoping to be in Finland, representing her country at the World Championships. Backstage, Angela Nikodinov of the United States, a smile on her face. When we saw her a little while ago, she was in tears following her performance. Amber Corwin, she was happy then, she's happier now. Now waiting for the marks for Fumiya Suguri.
And this triple lutz reminds me of Midori Ito several years ago when she crashed into the cameraman.
Fortunately, Suguri not hurt, colliding with the boards and able to finish her program.
Marks for Fumiya Suguri, 5-1, 5-4, 5-2, 5-3, 5-2, 5-0.
Carol, it won't be enough to get her on the podium. And so in the final standing, Suguri finishes in fifth place. Tatiana Malanina, the first ladies champion in the inaugural Four Continents Figure Skating Championships. American second, third, and fourth. When we return, the story of the pairs competition, including the most dramatic moment, which saw this frightening fall by the Canadian team during their warm-ups. We'll see what happened during their courageous return to the ice following that mishap. Tomorrow, the NBA on NBC, NBA Showtime, will have the latest news on the new Los Angeles Lakers. Then regional action. Game one features Orlando and Miami, or the Knicks and the Pistons. Game two, a Midwestern battle between Karl Malone's Utah Jazz and David Robinson and the Spurs. Finally, a primetime matchup, the Lakers and Houston. Meanwhile, here in Halifax at this brand new event, a look at the prize money won by the top skaters here. And our Beth Ruyak is with two happy Americans.
Thank you, Tim. Well, it was a very different night for each of you. Angela, I know that you're giving yourself a message about your skating, and you got a message this evening from the judges, too. How did you interpret it?
Well, I started really strong and kind of started going down in the middle in the slow part, and I knew I had to finish with the, you know, strong triple toe at the end, and I know what I have to work on when I go back home now.
Yeah, the frustration wasn't out there, but we sure saw it backstage.
Yeah.
And Amber, I don't think you could have been more elated at your finish and to a season that you really wanted to finish strongly to redeem nationals.
I came off nationals feeling really disappointed and really depressed, and so when I found out I was coming here, I was really excited because I thought this is a time to redeem myself, and I feel that I did. In the middle, I was a little weak, and I brought it back, and I was finished strong, and I was really proud of myself.
Well, there was a lot of pride out there in seeing the American ladies finish second, third, and fourth. Congratulations to you
both.
Thank
you very much.
Back to you, Tim.
Thanks, Beth. In the pairs competition here at the Four Continents event, the Chinese were the class of the field. Xu Shane and Hong Bo Xiao, fourth at the World Championships last year. Carol, they were spectacular.
And everything is done with a tremendous amount of speed. And look at this triple throw. Absolutely marvelous. Nobody can do it better.
The United States national pairs champions, the brother and sister team of Steve and Danielle Hartzell, were steady with some minor problems in their free skate, but they wound up in third place here in Halifax.
The brother and sister relationship definitely shows up in their skating.
Well, Carol, the most dramatic moment of the pairs event involved the Canadian team of Valerie Sauret and Jean-Sébastien Fecteau. You saw the terrible fall Valerie had in the warm-up. Well, 10 minutes later, they had to make the same throw again for real, which they did, to the delight of the hometown Canadian crowd, a courageous performance earning them fourth place. So a look at the pair's final results here in Halifax. The Chinese take first as well as fifth place. Canadian pairs wound up second and fourth, and the U.S. delivered a third and sixth. When we return, a look at Elvis Stoiko and the story of the men's short program.
ABC Sports coverage of the Four Continents Figure Skating Championships is brought to you by Genuine Chevrolet, the cars more Americans trust.
Back in Halifax, Nova Scotia, a reminder to log on to MSNBCSports.com and check out a special section, NBC Ski, Skate, and Board, for the latest figure skating news and features. Our Four Continents ladies champion Tatiana Malanina was seen checking out practice for the men's short program. Why? Well, she was watching her boyfriend, Roman Skornyakov, who's also from Uzbekistan, as Malanina is, and Skornyakov did not disappoint during the men's program last night. In the short, he finished a very respectable sixth. Takeshi Honda of Japan has been nursing a sore ankle since his country's national championships. But a little ice on the ankle before the ankles went back on the ice seemed to work. Honda was technically brilliant, Carol.
He made everything look so easy, and of course it isn't. He now trains with Elvis Stoiko, with the coach Doug Lee.
Perhaps a breakthrough short program for him, and Takeshi Honda grabbed the lead.
And look at this speed. Oh, he has so much height.
So Honda finished first ahead of the Canadian favorite, Elvis Stoiko. He doubled one triple jump and just missed a quad by landing on 2 feet.
And you can see here, trying to set up the quad, not quite around and had to two-foot it.
But quad figure skating history was made by Min Zhang of China, the first successful quad jump in an international senior short program, lifting Zhang into second place. The Americans didn't fare quite as well. Trifon Zivanovic was first on the ice for the U.S. His first jump combination, a slight problem.
He couldn't quite check out his free leg on the triple jump.
Shepard Clark also had a rocky start, falling on his attempted triple axel.
And started to swing on the takeoff, and there wasn't any way he could land.
And perhaps most disappointing after his third place at the U.S. Nationals, Timothy Gabel.
And Timothy wanted this so badly, he kept over-rotating on the landings.
Somewhat nervous performance by Timothy Gabel. And so a look at the standings after the men's short program. A surprising Takeshi Honda of Japan in first place. A surprising third for favorite Elvis Stoiko. Two Chinese among the top six. So the men's free skate competition promises to be a primetime battle of the quadruple jumps. You'll see it next Saturday night at 8 Eastern time. Please stay with us. Coming up next on NBC Sports, the World Nordic Ski Championships from Austria. A chance to see the most decorated Olympian in history, cross-country star Bjorn Daly. And later this afternoon at 5 Eastern, the USA Indoor Track and Field Championships. Sprinter Maurice Green going for the U.S. title against America's fastest men. That's it from Halifax and the Four Continents Figure Skating Championships. And so for Beth Ruyak and Carol Heiss-Jenkins, I'm Tim Ryan saying we'll see you next week. So long, everyone.